Now let us talk about querying data from Hive tables. Earlier we just created the data frame from the Hive table, and I have mentioned that you have to use data frame operations to process the data. However, Spark.SQL also can take the query, any standard query, and you should be able to process the data. You can directly join the Hive tables and you should be able to see the results. You don't need to create a data frame out of the raw tables and then have to come up with the processing logic using data frame operations. If you are comfortable with SQL, you should be able to pass that SQL query directly as part of Spark.SQL, and you should be able to process the data and create the data frame out of processed data. So in this case, if you just want to process the data from Hive tables directly, you just have to say Spark.SQL, and you can say search star from orders.show, and it will preview the data directly by querying the data from orders table, which is in Hive. For some reason, it is a bit slow today. See here, you got the data. So keep in mind that whenever you run any Spark.SQL command, it will always return data frame. Depending upon the type of action you have performed, it will actually get those results in the data frame. Even if you run show tables here, it is nothing but a data frame. And to actually preview the show tables, you have to say show. As of now, it is connected to the default database. If you want to switch to a different database, you can actually run use command, use training demo. So that is the database name. And even now, it actually created the data frame, but it doesn't have anything in that. So any Spark SQL command always returns data frame. So as part of Spark SQL, you can run standard Hive commands like show tables, show databases, use to switch the database. You can also say describe table orders. Again, it will create a data frame. If you want to see the results, you can actually say show. You can see that this table have four fields: order ID, order date, order customer ID, order status. If you want to get formatted output, you can say describe formatted orders. However, the data is truncated. To disable the truncation, you can say show off false, and it will disable the truncation, and you should be able to see the metadata in proper format here. Okay. So that being said, you can use any command and always it returns data frame. On top of these things, you can also write query directly. So as we have seen earlier, let's say I want to get revenue per date. I can say select order date. Again, I would like to pass it in multiple lines, and hence I have to say a triple quote, and then I can say select order date sum of order item subtotal revenue from orders join order items on order ID equal to order item order ID group by order date. So there is some typo here. So let us see. On order ID order equal to order item order ID and then group by, and you can see that it has actually returned a data frame. So we can actually say show and preview the data, and we can take it from there. So this is about querying data from Hive tables. You can run as complex query as possible using Spark.SQL.